So, hi everyone. So, in our last presentation session, we covered the test command, how we can make use of test. So, actually, there is an exist status. So, I explained what do you mean by an exist status. So, if the exist status is zero, then that means the command is executed successfully. So, if your exist status is non-zero, anything other than zero, then your command is not executed successfully. So, you can use your test command in three different ways. That is to compare two numerical values. So we saw the different operators we can use in order to compare two different numerical values. Then we saw how we can compare two strings or to check whether a given string is null or not. Then we saw how we can check the file attributes. So these were the things we were able to do with respect to test command. So in this particular presentation session, we shall try to understand the conditional statement which you can use in your shell programming. There are different conditional statements which you can use in your shell program. Let us see each one of them in greater detail. So the first conditional statement is if statement. So you already know what do you mean by an if statement. It is a two-way decision statement. So your if statement gets executed, it will check for a condition. If that condition is true, then the statements following that particular condition will get executed. If the condition is false, then this set of statements won't be executed. This is a simple if statement. So it is a two-way decision test statement. That means you are making two decisions. That means either if the condition is true, based on the condition, if it is evaluated true, you will execute this set of statements. If it is false, then you will not execute this statement. Then there is also if else. If condition is true, then execute this set of statement. If condition is false, then execute this set of statement. And also there is else if ladder. So else if ladder is used for checking multiple conditions. As you can see here, if this condition is true, this set of statement get executed. If this condition is true, then this set of statement. If none of the conditions are evaluated to true, then the statements in else will get executed. So this is mainly used in order to choose between alternatives. So here there are two alternatives. If this condition becomes true, you will execute this alternative. The condition is false, then you will execute this particular alternative. So this is how you can make use of your if statement. There are three different variations. So the first one is simple if else and the else if ladder. For each if, you need to end it with a fi. So the reverse of if. So as you can see here, for each if you are ending it with a fi. For each if you are ending it with a fi. So if command is successful, then what needs to be done? Then you need to execute this set of statements. That is how you can design your statement. So here is a small explanation with respect to if statement. If the command succeeds, the statement with then block are executed. If the command fails, then the statements with else block are executed. Command fail. So let us try to understand how we can use this particular if statement in a shell script. So we shall try to write a simple shell script to check whether a given integer is positive or negative. So when an integer will be called as positive, if that particular integer value is greater than zero, if the integer value is greater than zero, in that particular case, it will be called as a positive number. So if it is equal to or less than zero, then we are printing that number as a negative number. So this is the path actually in which your shell script is stored. So this needs to be written ash exclamatory mark slash bin slash sh. That means this is the particular path in which your shell script will be stored. En shell script barita idira ee shell script ee particular path alli store agutte. Next I am writing enter any non zero integer. I am writing any non zero integer. So I will enter some non zero integer in the sense that you need to enter integer other than zero. So because if it is greater than zero, it will print positive. Since you are not entering zero, it will, if it is less than zero, it will print negative number. Then you are reading the number. So the integer you are entering, that will be stored in num variable. So num variable, then you are checking the condition. If, so it, this should be within square brackets. If value of num, you are taking the value of num. In order to obtain the value of num, you need to use dollar $num. This will give me the value of num. If that particular value is greater than, if you are using greater than operator, you need to proceed with minus sign. We saw this already in the previous presentation session. If that particular num value is greater than zero, then you should printing, you are displaying number is positive number. Else, you will display number is negative number. So this is a simple shell script in order to check whether a given number is positive or negative. Okay. So this is the output. As you can see, first it will ask you to enter any non-zero integer. If you enter 5, so it will be stored in the num variable. Then you are comparing the value of num, that is 5, with 0. Since 5 is greater than 0, condition becomes true. Then you are displaying number is positive number. This particular information gets displayed. This is how your if statement will work. Now let us try to understand case statements. Which case statement? So you already understood how switch works in your C and C++, also in Java. How your C statement will work, a switch statement will work. There will be a choice, there will be an expression. So that expression will be matched with multiple cases. That particular expression will be matched with multiple cases. If the expression gets matched with any of the cases, then the following statements gets executed and you will come out of the switch. So if none of the expressions, if none of the patterns are matched with the expression, then you will execute the default statement, then you will come out of the switch. So this is how your switch block will execute. In a similar manner, the switch block executes in your shell script. So we shall try to understand how shell script makes use of this switch case statement in shell programming. So case statements is basically a multi-way decision statement. Why multi-way decision statement? Because there are many conditions you will be checking. There are many conditions. So this expression needs to be matched with multiple patterns. If any of the pattern gets matched with the expression, then corresponding statements gets executed and you will break out of the case. So that's why it is called as multi-way. This is used when we must choose among many alternatives. So here you can have many alternatives. So if the expression matches with one of the condition, then that corresponding alternative will get executed. So this also handles string test, but in a more efficient manner than if statement. That means you can make use of string also as an expression. So this can be efficiently used then compared to how it is used in your if statement. If a length use madthira, adukkinte efficient a use madthira. So this is the syntax for writing your switch case in shell script. So as you can see here, case expression in. So this particular expression will be matched with these patterns. So if the expression gets matched with pattern 1, then statement 1 will be executed. If the expression gets matched with pattern 2, then statement 2 is executed. If the expression gets matched with pattern 3, then statement 3 is executed. Then it will come out of the case. If none of the patterns are matched, there will be default that statement gets executed. This is the ending of your case. So as you can see here, this is the reverse, ESACE, case the reverse, ESACE. This is how you should write your switch case block in your shell script. So here how it works, let us understand how it works. I already explained how it works. So let us go through it once again. Firstly, the expression is matched with pattern 1. The expression is matched with pattern 1. If the match succeeds, then the statement 1 will be executed. If the match fails, then the expression is matched with pattern 2 and this process will continue as long as the expression gets matched with a particular pattern. One pattern with a match agorgano continue. Each statement is terminated with a pair of semicolon. You are not using a single semicolon. Here you need to use a pair of semicolon. This is the construct that is given by shell script. This can match only string but cannot handle numerical and file test. That means you can make use of only strings for an expression. You cannot make use of numerical values or file test. However, this can also handle numbers but treating them as strings. You can use numbers also as expression, but those numbers will also be treated as strings. Avanusa strings are treated. So this is very effective when the string is fetched by command substitution. So command substitution ella madbekadre, if you are treating numbers as strings, then it will be somewhat useful command substitution madbekadre. So let us try to understand how your switch block or case will work with the help of a simple shell script. So this is the script we are writing. This will display appropriate messages based on grade A to D. So yav grade irutte aa grade mele avange en message beko adana display madta idi. So let us try to understand how we can write this particular shell script. First, you are writing the path where your shell script is stored. This is the path where your shell script is stored. Then you are asking the user to enter the grade from A to D. Slash n stands for new line. So enter grade A to D. The grade entered by the user will be read into a variable called as grade. Grade on a variable ge a value na read madkotini. So in order to fetch the value of that particular grade, I am using dollar grade. So dollar grade, suppose iga D anta enter madide. So iga dollar grade alli D anta irutte. Case D. So I need to match the expression D with the following patterns. There are five patterns, that is A, B, C, and the default, which is star. So here, if A is the grade, then it will be excellent. It will be displayed as explained. Here B, well done. C, you passed. D, better try again. So in this case, we have entered D as the grade. So first, D will be matched with A, no match. D will be matched with B, no match. D will be matched with C, no match. D will be matched with D, match. Then it will print better, try again. If you are entered grade, any other grade, then it will print as invalid grade. So if I entered E as the grade, then it will come here and print as invalid grade. So this is the end of your case statement, that is switch block. Here I am ending my switch block. Finally, I am printing the grade. Your grade is dollar grade. That means your grade is D and the print agutte. So this is how your switch block will work. So this is just an example. First, it will ask you to enter grade from A to D. If you enter B, then the B will get matched. Then it will print, well done, your grade is B. This is how actually the shell script will work, and it will print as suggested in your case block. So let us try to understand some more examples with respect to the switch case statement. So let us see how we can match multiple patterns with respect to case. Case statement can also specify the same action for more than one pattern. As you can see, if there are multiple patterns, you need to match, but the action needs to be one. So pattern multiple irutte, but you need to perform one single action. Let us see how we can do that. For example, let us have a script to test a user response for both small y and capital Y, or small n and capital N. That means if the user enters small y or capital Y, or if the user enters n and or capital N, then the response should be same. Small y go capital Y go same response irbeku, same action irbeku. Small n go capital N go same response athava same action irbeku. Let us try to understand how we can write. So this is the first line, which indicates where your shell script will be stored. The shell script will be stored in this particular path. Then you are asking the user, do you wish to continue? You should press either yes or no. The user can press small s or small y or capital Y, small n or capital N. So the value entered, the variable entered, the letter entered will be stored in a variable called as ANS. So then case dollar ANS. So for example, if user has pressed small n, so in ANS it will be small n. So in order to get the value, you need to include dollar. So dollar of ANS under it will give me small n. So case small n in. So it will search for this particular pattern. YY match aglila. So it will come here. NN no anta banto. So if this is the case, exit. Illa andre this keeps repeating. For example, if I press Y anta bandre. So Y agidrinda I am not exiting here. So since I am not exiting, I won't come out of the case loop. Here exit martidarinda I will come out of the case. So this is how your switch block will work. So that means you can have a single action for multiple patterns. So here I am having two patterns, small y and capital Y. For both small y and capital Y, I am doing nothing here. So as you can see here, for both small y and capital Y, I am doing nothing here. So whereas for small n and capital N, I am doing same action, which is the same action, that is I am exiting. So this is how you can have same action for more than one pattern. So this is the second example with respect to case. Let us try to see one more example for case. So then we can move on to another topic. So this is how we can use wildcards. I already explained what is wildcards. So here we shall try to understand wildcards. What do you mean by wildcards? So they add some functionality, or I can say they add some matching. So whenever you are performing some matching operation, if you are using wildcard, then they add that extra functionality. So how we can make use of these wildcards in your switch case statement? Let us try to understand that. So case statement also can be used with wildcards for a string matching feature. That means you can make use of wildcards. So even with wildcards also, you can perform string matching with help of case statement. So let us understand how it can be done. So when you understand this particular shell script, you will get a better understanding. So case statement using file name matching meta characters. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಏನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫ್ರೇಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಟಾ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಮೆಟಾ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಝೀರೋ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಕರೆನ್ಸಸ್, ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಕರೆನ್ಸಸ್, ಓಕೆನಾ. ಸೊ ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಟ್ ಟು ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎ ಯೂಸರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಎಸ್ ವೈ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇಎಸ್ ವೈ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಇ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಸ್ ನೋ 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 ನೋ. ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲಾನು ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಗಳನ್ನ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಯೂಸರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಪಾತ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯುವರ್ ಶೆಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್. ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲೈನ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ಡೂ ವಿಶ್ ಟು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ, ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾ ಬೇಡವಾ ಅಂತ ಯೂಸರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಕೇಳ್ತೀರಾ. ಯೂಸರ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ವೈ ಆರ್ ಎನ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಸೊ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಎ ಎನ್ ಎಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಕೇಸ್ ಡಾಲರ್ ಎ ಎನ್ ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ಕೇಸ್ ಡಾಲರ್ ಎ ಎನ್ ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಯರ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎ ಎನ್ ಎಸ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಎ ಎನ್ ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯೂಸರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಡ್ ವೈ ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ವೈ ಐ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಅಂತ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಬಟ್ ಯೂಸರ್ ವೈ ಎಸ್ ಅಂತ ಎಂಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾನೆ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಎಂಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾರೆ, ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದು ಎಂಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಆ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ನಾನು ಬರ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ತರ ಬರ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಆಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಈ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಯಾವ ತರ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ವೈ, ಇಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಎನಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಝೀರೋ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಎನಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ ವೈ ಇ ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ವೈ, ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಇ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಎಸ್. ಇಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ವೈ, ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಇ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಎಸ್. ಇಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ವೈ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಎಸ್. This is how you can write a pattern with the help of wildcards. So here I am using the meta character star and question mark. So I am making use of this star meta character in order to enhance my pattern, in order to increase the functionality, or I can say in order to make my pattern much more effective, efficient. So similarly you can write for n. So you can see here n. So here as you can see here I am not including star. Why? Because I am checking only for no. There is no third character which is yes here in the case of yes. So it will first, for if the user press no, it will take small n small o, capital n capital o. If the user press capital n capital o, capital n small o, small n capital o. So if user press any of these four combination, then this particular pattern will get matched, then it will exit. So if the user press any combination other than this many combination, then it will print, this is the default, in that case it will print invalid response, then you will end your switch block. This is how it works, okay. This is how the actual working will take place. So this is how you can make use of wildcards in order to perform the pattern matching. So the expression will be matched with the pattern, but in this case you are making the patterns much more elaborate, or I can say effective, efficient, with the help of wildcards by using meta characters such as star and question mark. So we saw three major uses of your case statement: how we can match string, how we can have same action for more than one pattern, then also we saw how we can make use of meta characters or wildcards in order to frame the pattern. So let us try to see some more. So let us try to understand one more command which is called as expr. This is called as expression command. This is mainly used for evaluating an expression. If you want to evaluate an expression, then you can make use of expr command. So what are the two major uses of expr? It is used for evaluating an expression, so then the result will be outputted. The corresponding output value, which is found out after evaluating the expression, can be printed. So this command can perform two major functions. That means it can perform arithmetic operations or integer, or also it can perform some manipulations on strings. So these are the two major functions available with respect to expr command. So let us try to understand how this particular command can perform the numerical computation with respect to integer. There are five operators you can perform on integer: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and modulus. So the syntax for using your expr is expr, the first operand followed by the operator, then the second operand. So this is how you need to make use of your expr command. So let us try to understand the example here. Here the x value is 5, y value is 3. You are using the expr command. This is the command prompt. You are using the expr command. Then you are taking the value of x, which is 5. Then you are taking the value of y, which is 3. 5 plus 3 is 8. That will be outputted. So that is how your expr command will work. It will evaluate an expression. So once the expression is evaluated, then it will output the corresponding value. It will also print the value. That's why it is outputting 8. So in this case, it will be 5 minus 3, it outputs 2. So in this case, why we are using this particular character means star is a meta character. So if star is a meta character, it will be treated as wild card. So in order to make sure it is not treated as wild card, you need to escaping. We saw the concept called as escaping and quoting. So there we saw how we can remove the functionality of our wildcard. So you need to include escape character just before the wildcard. So here if I include escape character just before wildcard, it will be treated as multiplication symbol. It won't be treated as a wildcard. So that's why 5 into 3, it will print 15. So next, $x divided by $y, 5 divided by 3, it will output 1. Because 3.1 point something, since we are doing integer division, it will print integer value. So 5 mod 2, 2 is the remainder. So next time what I am doing, expression $x plus $y. So command substitution to assign a variable. Here what I am doing, first I am evaluating $x plus $y, it will be 5 plus 3, 8. So that 8 is assigned to a variable called as z. Then I am printing the variable z. So it will print 8. So you can, if you don't want to output the result, you can also assign that output to a variable. Later on, you can print that particular variable. So this is how you can make use of your expr command in order to perform the integer computations. So let us try to understand in what other scenarios we can make use of your expr command. So in string handling also, you can make use of your expr command. In string handling, it is used for three major functionalities. That is to find the length of a string. So extracting the substring from a given string. If there is a given string, if you want to extract only the substring, you can make use of this particular function called a command called as expr. Locating position of a character in a given string. So in a given string, if you want to locate the position of a particular character, you can make use of this particular expr command. So this is the syntax to make use of your expr command. expr exp1:exp2. So if we understand with the help of examples, then we will get a clearer picture. So on the left of the colon, the string to be worked upon is placed. So your string mele no operation apply madbeko adu left alli irutte. So right of the colon alli regular expression irutte. Yen operation apply madbeko anadu right of the colon alli irutte. So this is how you can perform string handling with the help of your expr command. So expr command is used for three major functionality: to find the length of a string, to extract substring, to locate the position of a character in a given string. So this is the syntax, expr command. This is actually the string itself. This is the operation to be performed on the string. So let us understand how we can find the length of a string. So the regular expression dot star is used to print the number of characters matching the pattern. So if I am using a regular expression called as dot star, so why dot star andre? Star, you know, zero followed by any number of characters. So dot andre dot followed by any number of characters. So adna use madidre you can find the number of characters matching the patterns. Okay, so as you can see here, the syntax is string dot star expression vtu note bsr. So here I am finding the length of the string. So zero followed by any number of characters. So eshtu number of characters irutte adna found madbeku andre ithara dot star use madidaga it will output 13, since there are 13 characters in this particular string. So expr, the string itself, colon followed by the operation you need to, or the regular expression which is to be placed. So this is the regular expression which you need to place. So let us see how we can extract the substring from a given string. So ee string alli one substring na extract madbeku andre heng madod anthe. So expr command can be used to extract a string enclosed by the escape character. So escape characters enide ee escape characters olagade nan en string na ittirthini adana enclose madakke. As you can see here, illi escape character illi string start aagta ide. Ee string end aakinta munche ond escape character aagbeku. So ido entire outer quoting madiral. Okay na, this is the regular expression you need to write in order to extract a substring from a given string. Given string is a substring extract mark. So this is the syntax: expr string double inverted quote escape key, then substring escape key close inverted comma close. As you can see here, expression, this is the string colon followed by double colon escape key. This is the string which needs to be extracted. So this will output string. So en string na barithira bracket olge that needs to be escaped, because otherwise wildcard tara treat madutte. So wildcard functionality remove aagbeku andre aa bracket gal ginta munche escape kina barkondirbeku. So this is how you need to write. So then to locate the position of a character, yavadaro one character yav position alli ide aa information beku andre, then this is the regular expression you need to use. So en character na search martta idira a particular character na akbitu illi search martana. As you can see, vtu node baser. So cap u andre this is the character class. So this is the character you are searching for, then star followed by u, it will count, star will count the number of characters before this. So ee character na search martane star en madutte the number of characters before u, including u, search madutte. So 1 2 3, so third position anta return madutte. So star eno zero followed by any number of characters. So ee u na yavaga search agutte avaga eshtu characters agittu ashtu characters na display madutte. This is how you can locate the position of a character in a given string. So these are some of the examples or some of the functionality of your expr command. This is used for performing numerical computation, used for performing string handling, that is to find the length of the string, extracting a substring from a given string, locating the position of a character in a given string. So now next presentation session we shall start with the looping statements. What are all the different looping statements which are available, how they can be implemented in your shell script. So far in this particular presentation session we saw the conditional statement, that is if else if ladder. We saw some examples with respect to if statement. Then we saw the case statement, how case can be used to have a single action for multiple pattern. Then we also saw how we can form patterns with the help of wildcards. So lastly we covered the expr command. So watch all your presentation session. So if you get any doubts with respect to any of the presentation session, ping me with your doubts and get it clarified. So now next presentation session we shall start with the looping statements. Thank you.